Hey guys, Sam here, and welcome back to another FIFA 18 experiment. Today's experiment is not actually an original experiment. My two good friends have both done this, once in FIFA 17, B-Monus did it, and in 2018, Rich Lee did it. But in 2018, Rich Lee did America as a whole, as general, so Central and North America, and B did it in the last FIFA, so I thought I'm gonna do it in FIFA 18, I'm gonna do Europe versus South America, two fantastic footballing continents in their own rights who've developed some of the best players that have ever played the game, and really the two major footballing continents. We're gonna see what happens when we put the best players from each continent and we're gonna put them up against each other in a league format and see which of these teams can pick up the most points, all the while taking a look at how they perform against each other in two simulated games, of course, throughout the season. If you go on to enjoy today's video, guys, do leave a like on the video and subscribe if you're new around here. The views and stuff has been crazy, the support has been crazy. I thank you guys every video, but I really can't thank you enough. So if you're new around here, subscribe and stick with us. Also, if you have any ideas for some FIFA 18 experiments, leave them in the comment section below. I probably won't do any more continents because Rich Lee has done a lot of them, so go check him out. I'll leave him in the description down below. But if you have any other different ideas for some FIFA 18 experiments, feel free to leave them in the comment section below, and you never know, they could turn into a video. Alright, so kicking things off in Europe, and the most successful team in Europe, with Real Madrid representing Europe. Up top, we have Robert Lewandowski. On the left is Ronaldo. On the right is Bale, with De Bruyne, Modric, and Kroos making up a midfield three. Jordi Alba, Ramos, Chiellini, and Carvajal are the back four, with Manuel Neuer in between the sticks, of course. Now, I could play a back three and make this team a little bit higher rated, but I want both teams to play a back four, and I want both teams to play 4-3-3, because I want to make it a little bit even. Both teams have pretty weak fullbacks, so I kind of want to make it a little bit more even, a little bit more fair. Taking a look at the bench though, it is Griezmann, Hazard, Kante, Silva, Hummels, Boateng, and De Gea on the bench. That is absolutely stacked. And the reserves are stacked as well. Courtois, Ibrahimovic, Robin, Thiago, Pique, Verratti, Pogba, Ozil, Bonucci, Hamsik, Eriksen, Lukaku, Isco, Rakitic, Iniesta, and Insigne. The names go on and on. Europe consistently bringing out the talent. Representing South America is Boca Juniors. I just picked a random South American team. I went with Boca Juniors just because I think they're one of the more notable South American teams. And my goodness, the attacking flair, the attacking talent South America produces is something else. It is unmatched. The attacking players that South America produced is unmatched. They are on another level when it comes to the attacking players. So the front three is Suarez, Neymar, and Messi, once again, together after Neymar's move to PSG. In the midfield, it is Dybala, Vidal, and Casemiro as a midfield three, with Marcelo, Godin, Silva, and Dani Alves. Edison is in between the sticks. Now, I do want to make sure everybody's aware, Keylor Navas is not in this team because he's Costa Rican, which technically is Central American. It's not actually South American. I want to make sure I don't make that mistake, and I want to make sure everybody knows why Keylor Navas is not in the team. The bench, Higuain, Aguero, Alexis Sanchez, James Rodriguez, Miranda, Alexandro, Rui, and then on the reserves, Cavani, Coutinho, Otamendi, David Luiz, Icardi, Felipe Luiz, Gomez, Fernandinho, Marquinhos, Jimenez, Jonas, Di Maria, Roberto Firmino, and Fabinho. So I'd say the depth lies more with Europe. Europe has more players like over 85, 86 rated. But when you take a look at the upper echelon of players, like the real talented players, Neymar, Suarez, and Messi are three of the best players in the game. Overall, I think you got to say that Europe's team is slightly better, and I mean very, very slightly. I think mainly the defense and the midfield, Europe just simply prevails. There's just too many box-to-box or central midfielders and too many good center-backs in Europe for South America to match up. I also want to point out that the teams I showed you won't necessarily be the teams that the CPU plays in the season. That is completely up to them how they want to play the team, so they'll make the changes accordingly. I've just put the team that I like to put to show you guys which players are there. Regardless of the result, let me know what you guys think. Which team do you like more, and which team do you think in real life would perform better? Let me know in the comments below. All right, so I've quickly put them in the Premier League here. We've taken out, I believe, Brighton and Huddersfield. They're the lowest rated teams on FIFA. I don't necessarily think they're the worst teams in the Premier League, but they are the lowest rated in FIFA. And really what this is going to be, because a lot of the big teams have lost some of their good players, is going to be which team drops more points rather than which team gains more points. It's going to be which team slips up, which team can be consistent against the smaller teams and pick up the points. And then when it comes to versing each other, that's going to be a big one. That's going to be where you can take points off your main rival. And speaking of that, we do have one game to show you before we take a look at the table halfway through the season. So without further ado, let's get into that game and let's take a look at who gets the upper hand in the first game between Europe and South America. Okay, here it is. Game one between South America and Europe is the South America home game, the Boca Juniors home game. And the lineups are the ones that I showed you for these games. And this is going to be interesting, man. It is a home game for South America, so it's going to be interesting to see if they could pull out the win. I assume for Europe, a draw is a decent result. But of course, neither team wants to lose. And that's really what it comes down to. As we head into the second half, it is still 0-0 and what looks like a cagey game. Higuain comes in for Messi. Griezmann comes in for Lewandowski. 20 minutes left on the clock. It is still 0-0. And you would assume Europe is happy with that. Griezmann picks up a red card. Hazard scores in the 82nd minute. And Europe get the late goal and steal 3 points from South America. Advantage Europe. So halfway through the season, that is what it looks like. Europe just has one loss to their name, and they look like they're a much better side than South America, who currently sit in fourth, tied on points with Manchester United, and behind West Ham by 4 points. And they've got 5 losses to their name. Of course, one was to Europe, but 4 other losses to their name. That is massive. I quickly want to point out Liverpool's record. 9 wins, 10 losses, not a single draw, which I just think is fantastic. But overall, man, Europe has put themselves in a fantastic position, and you would assume that the only way South America wins it from here is if they can beat Europe in the second match, which would put them still 9 points behind, and then they'd need them to slip up somewhere, but I just don't see it happening. Europe's team looks like it is flying. So game two between Europe and South America, and you would assume here if it's a Europe win that the league is absolutely over, no doubt about it. And considering that Europe won away, you would assume they'd win at home, but Vidal puts up South America 1-0 in the 15th minute, and Lewandowski brings it back in the 33rd as we enter the second half at 1-1. South America definitely not leaving this one without a fight. They're definitely going to go for the win, and it's going to be interesting to see. With 20 minutes left, can either of this team get an edge? Europe would be pretty happy with a draw. With 5 minutes left in the game, Lewandowski again. 88th minute, Robert Lewandowski with the winner for Europe. And his 2 goals are the difference there. And I'm sorry, South America, but it looks like you've just been absolutely outclassed by Europe here. But at the end of the season, Europe only lost 2 matches. And considering they didn't lose either one of them to South America, it's kind of interesting that they actually did end up losing matches, because you would assume South America is probably the toughest matchup they could get. Speaking of South America, they did climb all the way up to second, and they only lost 1 game in the second half of the season. That, of course, being to Europe. But other than losing to Europe, they went 18 games undefeated in the second half of the season, which puts them up in second, still 14 points behind Europe, which is a huge, huge gap. Arsenal in third, Leicester in fourth, Liverpool ended up drawing a bunch of games, so they came in fifth, Spurs in sixth, United in seventh, but these big teams have been weakened. Most of them have been weakened. So really the main 2 teams we're looking at is Europe versus South America. And the gap is 14 points, which is huge. Taking a look at the top goal scorers, Europe was pretty much carried there by Ronaldo and Thomas Müller, who both picked up 18 goals in the campaign, which is massive. And the only person that features in the top 15 for South America is Alexis Sanchez, with 14 goals to his name. Taking a little bit more in-depth of a look at South America, the other people that were involved were Paulo Dybala, 10 goals, 4 assists for him. Roberto Firmino picked up 8 goals, 4 assists. Messi, 8 goals, 1 assist. But overall, just not enough of the attacking players getting involved there. Coutinho in his 8 games picked up 3 goals, 2 assists, only playing 8 games. And when you compare that to Europe, Eriksen getting involved as well, 10 goals, 3 assists. Robin, 7 goals, 4 assists for him. Lewandowski only played 12 games, but he picked up 2 massive goals against South America, and he got 4 goals and 2 assists in his campaign. But overall, actually, for Europe, it was pretty much Ronaldo and Müller. 18 goals, 7 assists apiece. I mean, they were pretty much the main two there for Europe. So credit to Europe, man. They did what they had to do. They picked up a massive, massive win. And one last thing I actually want to do touch on, now that I've looking at the table once again, South America actually had the better defensive record, which I find quite strange taking a look at the teams. You would expect them to have similar attacking records, and you would expect Europe to have a better defensive record, but actually it turns out that South America had a better defensive record, conceding 3 less goals than Europe. Europe just went on an absolute tear, scoring 82 goals in the season. Like I said earlier, guys, that is the end of today's episode. I know this isn't an original experiment, and this might not be entertaining for a couple of you guys, but I wanted to see myself what would happen when Europe took on South America and see if my results came different compared to anybody else's. Either way, if you did enjoy it, please do leave a like on the video. And like I said at the start of the episode, if you have any other experiment ideas, leave them in the comments below. Like I said again at the start of the video, no other continents. I'm not going to be doing any other continent experiments, I don't think. So just any other different experiment ideas that you guys have, please leave them in the comment section below. And also leave a like down there on the comments that you want to see. I mean, the videos that you want to see. Leave a like on those comments, support them, and get them up to the top so there's a higher chance that I will see them. Other than that, guys, leave a like on the video, subscribe if you're around here. I hope you did enjoy today's video. I hope you had a good day. I will see you guys in the next one very soon. Keep it real.